For the first time in India, more than 10 lakh entrepreneurs of micro, medium and small enterprises went on a one-day strike across the country on 20th December 2021 against the steep increase in the prices of raw materials. After facing severe setbacks due to demonetization, hasty implementation of GST and the ill-conceived COVID-19 lockdown, the MSMEs are gasping due to an increased production cost. Various organizations in the MSME sector have been seeking the attention of the union government to find solution for the pressing issues of increased input cost and seeking financial aid for several months.
It is a very sad day to witness the MSME entrepreneurs have to resort to closing their factory for a day to wake up the union government to listen to their problems. It has never been heard of in the past. Employees have gone on strike, but this is the first time employers have shut their factories down to convey their displeasure, agony, pain, and the problems. If the government does not save them now, we can never see them again. It is not about the problem alone. It is about listening to the problems, listening to their views, listening to their issues. That is more important today, what is required.
Affected severely by the policies of the union government and the ill-planned lockdown in March 2020, and now by the steep increase in raw material costs, the All India Council of Association of MSMEs, with around 170 organizations in the MSME sector, have participated in the protest.
I'm Ramamurthy, spokesperson, ICA, All India Council of Associations. Actually, this is just a movement, and we have connected pan-India. More than 170 associations are there. See, the reason why we all made a peaceful demonstration is to draw the attention of the government. Just for the first priority is raw material, which is very, very important for us, for any small-scale industry. Without raw material, we cannot survive. And usually, raw material cost will vary from our product cost from 60% to 70% maximum, and sometimes 50% also. Now, in the present stages, it is crossing 80%, and the entire value addition we are not able to absorb in the market. And all MSMEs are suffering like anything, and our working capital is also eroded. And after pandemic COVID also, we all survived through emergency credit lending only. And in this moment also, I want to thank the Honorable Finance Minister for granting us that loan, which made a small start for every small-scale industry after pandemic. Now, due to this raw material prices, in case the whole lot is now vanished. All the working capital, what we were having, all the raw material, due to raw material price, it has been absorbed. And I'll tell you two things is happening now. Due to this high cost of raw material, there is a slowdown in the economy also in November, December. We are not getting the required orders, and we don't have the required working capital to operate. Before what we were operating, now only 50% we are all able to operate. And the bankers are also saying, yes, your working capital is, last year the turnover is less due to COVID, they are not ready to lend us more also due to this raw material prices. So both sides' cascading effort is very severe. And our first objective is to bring back the raw material prices to April 2015 level. This is what we have requested the Honorable Prime Minister to intervene. And as all the raw material suppliers are very big players in the field, and we are all very, very small, and we are got so much affected, and we depend on our survival, it's very difficult now. So what is our request is, please kindly intervene and have a talk with them, call us for a discussion, and have some mutual concern, and see to that that the raw material prices reaches the pre-COVID level, so that the inflation also will be controlled and the demand will also increase. This is one point. The second point is, please allow import of all type of raw material, remove the whole anti-dumping duty, so that the production what the government has given to raw material, that can be eliminated, so that a level playing field at least will be there. And when the demand supply is there, then at least undue increase of raw material will be controlled. From the factory side, in the supply chain, it moves from the factory side, then to the next level. And before it reaches the small-scale industry, again, there is a huge rise in the raw material prices. So this is not actually been absorbed in the market, and we are finding it very difficult to sell our own product. Then in the supply chain in manufacturing side also, there is a problem. And those are supplying to all the public sector companies, government orders. There is no absolutely price escalation clauses. So then what can we do? Everywhere we are being hit. One side, after pandemic, just we are able to survive. And now due to this, we have got affected. And we are expecting a very quick solution. That is the reason we all closed down for one day across India, and in a very peaceful manner, and showed our solidarity that we are, and all of the raw materials have been bought by the MSMEs now. You can even make a survey. All large-scale companies doesn't buy no raw materials. We buy raw materials and we evaluate and supply to them, even to the government companies or the PSUs also. And the product doing also, the same thing is happening now. So total vicious circle is in MSME is staging a different environment now. So this cost cannot be absorbed by us, and we are not able to sustain. That is why we are asking. And fix an MRP for this, at least once in 3 months, they should not change the prices. Every day they are changing as gold prices. And every day we cannot give quotation and change our prices. And we all operate at the present stage. You just verify with any MSME units, we are operating below 5% of margin only. This is our state now. All due to this high cost of import, labor, everything is there. And this leads to unemployment also. In the future, definitely now itself, we are slowly reducing our manpowers, and this will lead to that also. So this is our humble request to the government, the respective ministries also, and to the Honorable Prime Minister to kindly intervene and solve our problem and call us for a discussion so that we can tell our plights to them and we can even, we are represented in our memorandum. Like agencies like NSAC or any government agencies can buy materials in bulk and distribute to us so that the cost advantages will come directly to us.
MSME entrepreneurs from more than 10 states participated in the demonstration. Tamil Nadu and Karnataka saw massive participation in the protests and the strike. The MSME units in the two important hubs, Chennai and Coimbatore, came to a standstill on the protest day.
Across India, pan-India, we estimate more than 10 lakh industries have participated in this, and all the major associations across India have crossed in Tamil Nadu, entire Tamil Nadu, in Karnataka, entire Karnataka, like Belgaum, Pinya industrial estates, Mysore, and they have all the industrial parts in Madhya Pradesh, Maharashtra, Pune, Gujarat, where all the industries are concentrated fully, almost 7 to 10 states has been covered.
The livelihood of the huge workforce, directly and indirectly employed in the sector, is also in trouble because of the crisis.
MSMEs employ roughly around approximately 12 crore people across India. And we are all interdependent on one among us, and it will be more than 40 crore people, one third of population. This is what we say from MSME. We hope the concerned ministries will call the respective raw material buyers and have a dialogue with them and give us a possible solution.